on the this section, hidden section, classical section. Here also there's a mix only. Okay? Clear? So now I am showing the brain stem. So for the brain stem you will have it. This is the ventral aspect and this one is the dorsal aspect. Okay? So along the ventral aspect, so these are the two
pedunculus.
So now this is the cerebral aqueduct. This is midbrain. This is cerebral aqueduct. Okay. So you can see the substantia nigra clearly. Segmented area, substantia nigra. Okay. Now, coming to this dorsal surface. Along the dorsal surface, we have four elevations. Carpora quadris. So these are the superior colliculus, inferior colliculus. So these are separated by the cruciate sulcus. Is it not? So the vertical limb of the cruciate sulcus, which lodges the pineal gland. This is the pineal gland. So this vertical limb of the cruciate sulcus lodges the pineal gland. Here you can see clearly pineal gland. Okay. Then you can see that this brain stem is connected to the cerebellum by the three peduncles. Okay. So these are the superior cerebellar peduncles, middle cerebellar peduncles, inferior cerebellar peduncles. Okay. Parallelly cut down to this middle and the middle cerebellar peduncles. Okay. So here we have the superior cerebellar peduncles. So both the superior cerebellar peduncles are there connected by the superior medullary venum. It is the nervous tissue. Superior medullary venum. Okay. This is nervous. Why it is nervous? So here you can see the fourth cranial nerve, which is the only cranial nerve which comes from the dorsal aspect. So here on the both the sides you can see the fourth one. Is it not? Fourth cranial nerve, the trochlear.
Okay,
you can see very clearly. Fourth cranial nerve. Okay, so that is the this dorsal aspect of the midbrain. And along with that, so what you are seeing is the
fourth ventricle.
Okay, which is the cavity which is present between the pons and medulla oblongata and the cerebellum. This is the tenth like diamond shape cavity. So here you can see the diamond shape. Okay, so what are the structures which present surrounding the fourth ventricle? Like we have the anterior median fissure is there, lateral to that we will have the pyramids. So why they are called as pyramids? Here we have the pyramidal tracts, the corticospinal tracts, the corticonuclear tracts are present here deep to this elevations. Okay, so that's why this area is called as pyramids. Okay, so here we will have the anterior median sulcus is there, this is anterolateral sulcus, and this is posterolateral sulcus. So here we will have the pyramids, lateral to these pyramids we will have the olives, oval like structures. Okay, olives. Then we will have the inferior cerebellar peduncles. Okay, understood?